Hello and welcome to Latest TV. I'm Viktorija Faith. In the first part today, our art correspondent Andrew Kay talks to artist and filmmaker Gary Thomas about his installation Lost Memories, which looks at Alzheimer's through his experience of caring for his mother.
Well, I'm delighted to be joined now by Gary Thomas. Gary, you've put together an installation which is video-based, which is being shown across the country in 5 locations, but it's a very personal project about 7 years in which you've been looking after your mother, who has been suffering from Alzheimer's. How did this all start?
Yeah, thank you. So I was looking for a project. It was during COVID, and I was looking for projects that I could work on from home. And I've had quite a lot of success with the Arts Council. They've been very good to me. So I was looking for something that Arts Council might fund. And I know they funded plays about dementia. I know Julie McNamara had a play about her mother who had dementia. And so this was kind of an interesting subject that I thought I could make a piece of work about, but also explore what it is. And so it became just something that it became, first of all, it was an Arts Council application, but also with that I had loads of photos and video on my phone, because I just kind of record and take photos all the time. And so I just thought that's what the film installation would be. So I wanted something that I could kind of, in some time, that I could put all that together. And then I got the funding, thankfully, and then in talks it became this much bigger kind of 4-screen film installation. Now it's a 3-screen film installation. So yeah.
Where did your mother live at the time? Were you close by?
So we lived together actually at the time. So yeah, so I was looking after her. And as David Parker came on board as a producer, and he said, one time I was saying, I don't know how many people are lucky enough to get to do this kind of work. And he was like, I don't know that many people that would do it, that would want to kind of make such a personal thing. So it didn't even really occur to me that, I was trying to make this film and it at the same time as still caring for my mum. So yeah, so it and then actually what happened is I was trying to start editing something just to put something together to get an idea, and then my computer kept on crashing, so I literally had to hand it over to someone else. Like, it was a sign telling me that I probably shouldn't be doing the two things at once. But yeah, David became the perfect person to kind of oversee it, and in talks we discussed a lot about what the film installation could be and what shape it could take. And yeah, so it's been a really good process.
And was your mother able to be aware of what you were doing at the time?
Not really. I didn't really tell her a lot about it, I guess. She was very aware sometimes of when I was taking photos of her, and sometimes she wasn't. She's very aware of when I there's some film at the end of us on holiday, and she's very aware of the camera, and I tell her to look into the camera and say hello and stuff like that. So sometimes she was aware and sometimes she wasn't. And she always knew who I was. And then in 2021 she went into a care home, and that put a bit of distance in a way, kind of between us. And that was a very difficult decision, but that also became slightly easier, on me as the only carer.
It's very interesting that as we move forward in time and people live longer, people of my age now being less able still have parents alive. I mean, did you find that strain as well?
I did, yeah. I mean, my mum died last year. It was, and I heard lots of things about Alzheimer's, and it was, I think we had such a close relationship that people don't often have, I guess, but she always knew who I was. So without Simon's, you say you lose a person twice because
Yes.
they're not really there. But yeah, my mum always knew who I was, and I think just because we had that close relationship and that close bond, she went into hospital, and I went in to visit one day, and I could see her kind of pulse in her chest, and I thought she's not going to go anywhere soon, you know. So yeah, it's kind of interesting, we never kind of, and lots of people say, and I say it's like if I die. You know, it's like we're all going to die, but we don't always talk as if, you know, that is good, that is inevitable. So I think it's interesting that, yeah, people are living longer. And luckily, my mum was able to pay for care. And after quite a while, we were able to get free care on a Tuesday. And then that process, we ended up paying for all day on a Tuesday. And then half a day on a Friday. So even when I was at home, a carer would come in and help. So we had that,
Yes.
you know, we could afford that support, but that's because my mum had, you know, been living for so long that she was getting a pension and everything. And so yeah, it is interesting. And I'm glad that I had the time with my mum that I did, especially in the
Now,
later years.
I'm assuming that during this installation, we see scenes that are very sad, perhaps distressing. But there are also moments of pure joy, I'm hoping.
Yeah, definitely. And there's video of us on holiday and things like that. And so yeah, and my mum was quite a character, and there's also it shows a scene of my mum running the butterfly appeal and going on stage, and they raised, you know, money for her charity. My mum and stepdad had a charity called the Butterfly Appeal. And so you see that in the film. And so you kind of see how she kind of was and like. And that's really nice, but then you also see her, the funny side of her, you know, and enjoying herself on holiday. And there were lots of moments like that where sometimes, because I was trying to get her to do things, then it kind of, we almost forget about the Alzheimer's because the mind is occupied, you know, by something else. And then I just written an article, and I was thinking about Andre Rieu, and anytime I put a concert on of Andre Rieu, you know, she would pretend to conduct like she was there, and anything to do with music she really loved. And so yeah, there's moments like that of us dancing together as well and not being on holiday. And that is, it's something. And also to kind of make a film like that where those, because a memory becomes something on video, becomes a memory if you film it, becomes a file. And then it becomes like all these files that you have on your computer that kind of get lost. So actually in making the work, you know, they become much more solid as memories, because this is a kind of, you know, a film in itself. So it was a really good process to look at that and get to look at those moments. And David went through and picked, so I didn't see all of them. But yeah, it was nice to have someone else kind of choose those moments as well as me.
And is it possible for you to watch the film yourself, or do you find it upsetting?
Yeah, I've seen it. We were in Bristol in June, and that was the first stop of the tour. And actually, we were setting up, and it was really nice. And because my mum died last year, I feel like it was quite soothing in a way, because I'd made this work. And what is also great is the comments that people have had about the film installation. And Bristol, it was a three screen installation, and in Worthing, it's going to be a single screen film in a gallery. But yeah, it's kind of a affirmation, I guess, of you know, I'm a filmmaker and I'm an artist, and but I'm most proud that I took that time to care for my mum, you know, of all the things that I've done. So there's that affirmation of watching the film and those memories, but also people's reaction to the film, and they're reacting to the person that my mum is as well. So that's then getting positive feedback from that is actually really nice. So yeah, I've seen it a number of times, and I can watch it.
And where in Worthing can we come to look at this?
So it's on in Worthing from the 3rd to the 7th of September. at Colonnade House, which is a lovely gallery in Worthing Town. And on the Thursday, the 5th of September, I'm going to be interviewed by fellow artist Rachel Gadsden in a Q&A in the evening. So that's very exciting.
Well, it sounded wonderful. I'm looking forward to seeing it myself. And
Thank
thank
you.
you so much for talking about me. I think it's wonderful that you've been able to capture those moments with your mother and the work that you did looking after her. It's a lesson to us all, really, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Thank you. And that's the other thing, is we're trying to highlight carers' responsibilities and open up that conversation. And also, we're inviting people to submit a piece as well, in either in writing or video, about their own caring journey. So hopefully that will be included in the exhibition in the months to come.
Well, thank you so much. Congratulations on your achievement. I hope you get the audience you deserve in Worthing and across the country.
Thank you for
Thank you
having me.
very
Thanks.
Did pass around.
Oh God.
Earlier on.
Yes.
This is lovely here. It was quite warm, really.
Gary, is your mum worried about any particular thing?
Yeah, she has panic attacks quite a bit, quite frequently. She forgets certain things, asks the same question over and over without realizing.
Does your mum live on her own?
No, we live together. So official confirmation came on Wednesday that my mum has Alzheimer's. I'll need to learn how to spell it, though thankfully it's on my phone dictionary. Why are you upset? Huh? Why are you upset? No, they don't. Nobody thinks you're stupid. Oh, do you want to come and watch a film?
With you.
Yes. Come in the lounge.
Yes.
Thank you, Andrew. Stay tuned because in part two, I will be joined by Andrew to talk about what's happening on Brighton music scene. Welcome back to Latest TV with me, Viktorija Faith. In this half, we're talking all things music. Hi, and welcome to Latest TV. And today I'm with Andrew Kay.
Hi, Vicky.
Hi, Andrew. So what's been going on this week?
Well, I've been talking about acts that are from my youth. And one of the big names back then was actually a Brighton local boy, Leo Sayer. He was discovered here in Brighton by another local pop music icon, David Courtney. David found him at an audition and took him on as his manager, but then co-wrote a lot of his hit songs, and they're amazing songs. He was an extraordinary new talent on the scene. Should we have a listen?
I would love to listen.
Same time every night at the Mexican discotheque. She gives him French kisses, he gives her French cigarettes. They sit at the same table every time. The lights are low, but their eyes shine. Just digging the music from those sweet soul bands. She keeps him out of fight, holds on to his hand. He whispers slowly, tonight's the night. Months of planning, so it's gotta be right. Under the table, her bag is bursting at the seam. She made sure to bring everything. They're gonna make it. 'Cause the disguise is a must. When they go missing, they're gonna look for the van first. She whispers slowly, "It'll be alright." I took some cash from my building.
I really enjoyed that.
It's great, and the songs were fantastic. They were real pure pop. But he did something else that was happening at the time, which was dressing up. So we'd come through glam rock. And we were going to this era which was heading towards New Romantic, where people were dressing up. He dressed up as a clown.
Wow, so a little bit like David Bowie, would you say?
There were definite parallels there. And David Bowie's Ashes to Ashes video, where he was dressed as Pierrot, was very similar, in a sense, to what Leo was doing. I mean, it was really at the advent of people making these big dramatic videos to release with their songs. I mean, the first one that was really big, of course, was Kate Bush. And that was very much about dressing up. Dressing up became a really big part of the pop scene. And fan scene, we all dressed up. I mean, I dressed up all the time. So I wore far too much makeup back then.
So is that how it was in like 70s and 90s?
More in the 80s. And it was, you know, it was a great time for music. And Leo had a huge career, not only here in the UK, but he had number ones over in the States. And Leo can still fill enormous arenas, which is why this is extraordinary, because he's playing the Assembly Rooms in Worthing, which is not an arena. And he's there actually very soon on the 5th of October. I think that's going to be a great opportunity. Obviously, he's on his home ground. He'll be excited about that. His fans will be really excited to see him up close.
Well, I'm definitely going to go there and see him and hope everyone else will too. Today, actually, he's going to talk about one of the bands that I actually know. It's 10cc.
And I'm so pleased that you know the name of the band and this particular song, because it was such a big hit back in 1975. When I was 19 years old, it was the theme that summer for everybody. And it's sort of a weird song because it's called I'm Not In Love. Shall we listen?
Oh, I'd love to listen to that song, yeah.
Actually, they were playing it back in 2011, but the song's 49 years old and it still sounds as good as ever, doesn't it? It's amazing. And I think they'll still have a big, strong audience, but they're playing a big venue in Eastbourne. So I think the audience for this one might be people of my generation.
Right. And when are they going to be?
Oh, they're at the Congress Theatre in Eastbourne on the 18th of October. And I think it'll be packed because I think people in their 60s will know that song so, so well. It means a lot to a lot of people.
Yeah. It plays a lot at advertisements or not?
No, it's been used in so many media formats. Yeah, it really has. But I think it's sort of, for those of us who were teenagers, late teenagers at that point, it was very poignant. We were probably all going through breakups of relationships and it was the sort of soundtrack for our tears.
Yeah, so I'm really excited for this one, and hopefully younger people also going to come and check this band out and just to see how older generations are performing on stage. So
they are very true. A lot of bands from those days are out on tour this autumn.
Yeah, and we're going to go and see them all. Thank you for watching. Come back soon for Latest TV.